Cosmic Skeptic does not understand Name the Trait. And apparently some of the viewers of my video refuting Cosmic Skeptic don't understand it either, and or they did not understand my arguments. So let me yet again break it down so that it could forever and consistently remain broken. I'm talking about Name the Trait now. So, without giving you any valid reason as to why you should accept Name the Trait as valid, Cosmic Skeptic asks you to name the trait. Funny. Now, you don't have to play this game, but if you choose to play this game, play the game you must. And the reason why I choose to play the game is because I know how to beat the game. So we play. But if you were to name the trait human, Cosmic Skeptic will reject that trait. So he asks you to play the game Name the Trait without giving you any valid reason for why you should. Yeah. And then you play the game and you name the trait. He rejects the trait. He rejects you naming the trait, thereby rejecting Name the Trait. So a game he assumed was valid, a couple of seconds later he tells you is not valid, contradicting himself. But then he goes on to use Name the Trait to debunk meat eaters by presenting these straw men such as intelligence. And the reason why that is a straw man is because, well, no one ever in a conversation or a debate with him presented him with this trait. Or at the very least, he never presented us with evidence of this. So no one is actually, to him, making this argument. He is building a straw man. And the reason why he builds a straw man is because men made out of straw are highly flammable and easily burned down to the ground, right? So once again, after he assumes that Name the Trait is valid, he rejects Name the Trait, only to act as if Name the Trait was yet conveniently again valid. The guy's all over the place. He's incoherent. He's flip-flopping, contradicting himself, refuting everything he says himself on his own. I'm just pointing it out. Not only that, he also goes on to name a trait that is supposed to validate Name the Trait as, well, legitimate, without telling you that that's exactly what he's doing, and perhaps he himself doesn't understand it either. He names the trait that plants lack, that animals and people do possess, that makes it okay to eat plants but not animals or people, or veganism. And that trait is sentience. So while he rejects the trait human on the grounds that it is subjective, which is interesting coming from a moral subjectivist, very interesting. How do you justify that? How do you reject a subjective basis for morality when you yourself are a moral subjectivist? How do you do that? I'm telling you, this kid is incoherent. But he rejects your trait human because it's subjective, as he says, and then he proposes his own trait, sentience, which is no more or less subjective. That line that he draws between plants and humans and animals is very much subjective. Me drawing the line between humans and the rest of the living beings on this planet, how is that any more or less subjective than what he does? It's not. So the same reason he gives for rejecting my trait is the same reason by which we can reject his own trait. The kid refutes himself. He's incoherent, hypocritical. So when it's convenient, because veganism, Name the Trait is valid without any justification for why that is. But then when it's inconvenient, because, well, I could draw the line wherever the hell I want to as well and justify it by means of Name the Trait just the same, then Name the Trait becomes invalid all of a sudden. But here's the kicker, you guys. My trait, human, whether you believe is subjective or objective, doesn't really matter. But it is the only valid trait in this instance. And it makes perfect sense, actually. Why? Well, because the very premise on which Name the Trait rests, without which Name the Trait cannot work, now that it does anyway, but the premise on which it is built, the very first premise is, quote, humans are of moral value, unquote. Now let me ask you this, why are humans of moral value? Thanks for watching.